Really good, right?
Oh.
No, I wasn't here last week. They changed me last week. I didn't drink last week because I wasn't here. But 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. Hey Jesus, we want to sit next to you on the throne. And Jesus explained to them that he loves all people. And then 2 weeks ago, who did we talk about that was our example? Who was our example 2 weeks ago? Peter taught and wrote in the book about how to be a leader. If you don't remember that, you can look that up online and see the message again anytime. Yes, all the sermons are on death, liberty. BaptistChurch.com, and you can see all the sermons from everything. You can watch them again, and then last week, Clay James will be on there. And so, now again, today we will be talking about the servant leader's call. So, some of y'all sign it this way because missionary and travel, but I signed it this way, call. Why do I do that? Because Paul founded the church and Peter helped him. So right next to P on top, and Paul founded it, so I put the P on top for Paul and P on the side to be able to call.
Thank you.
fire definition is to you, you're not all taxes, but this can still apply to your life. I will be speaking six different kinds of qualifications that can also apply to your life. If you want to become a leader, it is necessary to have this. It doesn't necessarily mean that you will become a pastor because you have these things, but these things will help you give you the ability to be a better leader. Having his children in subjection with all gravity. For if a man have not house, he will his own house. How shall he take care of the church of God? Not a novice, lest being lifted up with pride, he fall into the condemnation of the devil. Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into the we will be taking six points from the past options. The qualifications of what is necessary for you to become a good leader. I'm curious. Do you remember when I say leader, what who does that mean to think of? Who's the first person that comes to mind when I say leader? Who do you think of? The first thing that pops into my mind when I think of a leader is the President of the United States. That's what I just think of as a leader. That's something that I first think of. Right now, our President Obama, I'm not talking specifically about him, but as President, just as being a president in general, should they get in trouble? Someone mentioned Clinton.
Obama!
And his sign name was this. And why is that? Because you lie. I think that's interesting. That Clinton did even many wonderful things in the office. Not the best president. But he did good things as a president. You don't remember him as President Clinton, he signed President Clinton with this. He lied. It's interesting. He lied. He was a liar. He was there, and he had issues there. And so when you look back, you think of him that way. So now we as leaders, we will have the same. You want to become a leader in the community, or you want to become a leader in your church, or in a Sunday school class, or a leader in the group, or a coach, or whatever. These principles apply to your life. I'm not going to be a leader. Well, someone just mentioned, even as a mom and dad, you're a leader in that position. Typically, someone will look up to you. Someone somewhere is looking up to you. Who is that? I don't know. Not all people can become leaders, but it is important to understand these principles and that they can apply to your life. So I'm going to take six key points of view, and we'll talk about that today. First one, social qualifications. Notice here in the passage it says, give it to hospitality. What does hospitality mean? Being friendly, having an open invitation. You know, a hotel usually is known for hospitality, a welcoming, guests in, a clean environment. They look very welcoming, and that's how we should be. Notice at the end of verse 7, it says, even more, you must have a good report of them which are without. So even from those that are from the outside looking in, we should have this report. I'm pretty new here in Kansas. I've been here maybe 3 months now. And sometimes I'm out meeting some people, some might be deaf, and we might get into a conversation, and I might ask, oh yeah, do you know George or Mike Lewis? And I'll start naming some people from this church, and they'll say, oh yeah, I know who that is. So what do you think they might say about that person, about you, if I were to mention your name? What do those people on the outside think? If all of you were to go to Jackson, Florida, oh, hey, do you know Marcus Pruitt? Do you know that guy? Yeah, I know Mark. Oh, man. He was not a good basketball coach, or his teaching was horrible, or and his signs were so hard to understand. And you might think, oh, I thought I knew him. That might be shocking to you. I mean, he's been here for 3 months now, and he's been fine. And then you go over there and ask about me, then, you know, that might be interesting. Are they lying? Could they be lying? I mean, I don't know. But we want to become good leaders, if we want to become good leaders, we're going to need to have a good support from the people looking on the outside. When people look at death of leadership, what do they think of? What does that look like to them? Do they think, oh, that church, the people here, the people there, oh, they lie, or represent God, Jesus Christ, right? We're representing God, our church, this church. Is it representing deaf people only? Well, I mean, it represents deaf, but number one, who? Jesus Christ. If our behavior is shown poorly, then our reputation will not be good. So I encourage you to think. About what do people think about me? The people on the outside looking at me. What do they think about me when they come to me? Is it a good report? Where does it fall on the ABCDF scale? That say, oh yeah, DLBC, they just talk about Jesus all the time and it's just overwhelming. Well, then that's a great example. I mean, that's great. We want them to say that. Oh yeah, that's great. All they do is talk about Jesus and well, that's good. That's fine. But as far as thank you. that's really important. That's important for our church today. Today, technology is amazing. It's so easy to pull the video. I mean, Pastor Olson is in China, and he sent us a video of what's going on over there. That's just crazy. Our lives are on display so the whole world will see. Every time you post on Facebook, every time you take a picture and put it on Instagram, or send a text, or make a phone call and leave a message, you've got to be careful every time. Just yesterday, I was texting someone. And this particular woman was kind of shifting blame on me, and I almost said something that I shouldn't have. And I actually started texting, and I had to delete it before I sent it. I have to be blameless. If I were to say something mean and turn it right back around on her, that could go out and say, oh, look what Pastor Mark said to me. You gotta be careful. When you say something, you have to be careful. Be blameless. Watchful. Careful. Not here to whine. In control. You have control. Not greedy of money. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 12 through 13. This other guy was also on television, and he caught for he was a pastor in Indiana of a big church over there. What was his name? Jack Hiles. After Jack Hiles, this is the man that became the pastor of that church. He had a lot of problems too that came up. Do you think that they planned this? They planned that their goal was to mess up my church, mess up my reputation, so that everyone would not like me. Was that their plan? No, that was not their dream. They never dreamed that these things would happen. And temptation comes along and they're tempted and they get drawn into it. Having good morals is very important. A lot of people have left the church, left God, the same God, because of our example and our mistakes. We can push people away. Does it mean if we did make a mistake, we can't change? No, we can change. We can get back. We can. Actually, 3 of the 4 of these men are back in ministry again. They apologized and betrayed their mistakes and accepted their responsibilities and whatever consequences, whatever they needed to do to go from there. They accepted that and moved on and got back. But you know, a lot of people were hurt from them. So I encourage you, think about your morals and that your decisions can affect the church, it can affect other people. Sometimes we make decisions. We have to make decisions fast. And sometimes we have tough decisions. Sometimes when we make a decision, it's right or wrong. And we just have to be ready. And as leaders, we have to be ready to make the right decision. Not only able, but ready. It says, not as a striker, a brawler. Do you want to be a fighter? Do you always like to fight and cause arguments and always get into big discussions? It's really hard for a leader to be successful that way. The communication of a leader Here in America, we have instant gratification, satisfaction, instant satisfaction. Oh, wait, hold on a minute. Let me pull out your phone. Oh, okay, it's on for you. Okay, what were you saying? Oh, wait. Is that what you're trying to do? Facebook. Oh, wait, I gotta check Facebook. Hold on a minute. Person needs me. Have that patience to sit and talk with them. Maybe some kind of patience will help one solve the problem. Think about it. People can't get along with me. Then maybe it's time for you to change the way you do things. For example, if I'm talking with my wife and I say, hey, Christine, can you make me a sandwich? Or go ahead, make me a sandwich. Go make me a sandwich. And she might say, hey, that's rude. So I need to change my approach. And they can say, hey, Christine, are you busy? Oh, I'm really busy right now. I've got to finish this project. Well, do you mind making a sandwich? Maybe that's a little better, right? You think about how you approach people and approach them in the right way and how you talk to them. Like, oh, you need to do these things. Or you say, oh, hey, do you mind helping me with these things? Or, and you don't say, oh, I don't like that. I don't like how you're talking to me. Be gentle with how you're helping people. And that you're pushing them, it's not really important. out, and then maybe 8 years improves a little bit, twice a week, a lot more. But when I first met my wife, I didn't really know how to communicate well with her. We made many mistakes. In our first year of marriage, I think the first year of marriage is beautiful. Oh, I like that song better. Cartoon. It says, Dolly hit me back. That means he hit her first. And then he's crying saying, Dolly hit me back. It's funny. Does that mean we have to be married to become a leader? It doesn't say that. Paul was not married. But it is important if a man were to get married, that he is faithful to one wife. You know, maybe, I've had a divorce before and made a mistake before. Well, that's okay. That happens. So now what do you do now from here on out? You change. You do better. You do differently. Having control. Like at home, my finances are a big mess. And then I come to the church and say, hey, I want to help the church finances. No, of course not. If my strength is in finances and I budget well and I know what to do at home, then I would be able to help the church. Or maybe say, I'm good at carpentry. I can do that at home. I do a lot of stuff. Fixing up at home so I can do that at the church. Or for me, I do not have a dream job. I do not have, you know, not into gardening, and I don't know much about it. But, so I just come in here like, oh, I can help with this. But it's not my skill. But whatever my skills are, I can bring that to the church. It's like, what are you doing at home? And you're able to build your home, and you can be a better leader in church. You can stay in home as probably practice. Go practice in your home. When you're successful in the home, then you're able to come to the church and serve. Last one, maturity. Usually it would be people got saved and baptized, and they would immediately start preaching. Not a novice. Maturity. Well, I know how. Oh, I heard it one time, and now I know how to do it, and I'm experienced. That typically means what? You're like, oh yeah, I know what I'm doing. What is that? Pride. Depending on myself. You have to be careful. What? My vision is still that I can talk pretty well with people. A good communication with someone. But if I depend on myself, I have to be careful because I can be surprised. Depending on myself and what I can do. Instead, asking God to fill me with His power and His glory and His ability and to lead me and be in my strength the right way. You want to be ready, you don't want to get stuck and not know what to do. Sorry. past or who have messed up. Who messed up or some church leader who might have molested someone or just over and over you hear all these stories. Why? We are leaders. Don't think, oh, I will never do that. That will never be me. Well, be careful. You see someone else fall into it, you think to yourself, okay, evaluate myself. Make sure that, you know, that could happen to me. And get focused. Not think, oh yeah, well, so-and-so needs to work on that one. No, we can think about ourselves.